So my name is Lorraine Bratlin. I have a business name. It's PIG, and that stands for Paranormal Information Gathering since 1996. I run an ad in the paper in the White Horse Star and have for so many years I've lost count. Mostly what people talk to me about is things that have happened to them years ago that they've never found anybody to report to. Then when they report to me, they're hoping that maybe I can let them know that other people have reported the same thing. In all the years I've been doing what I do, I've never heard the same report twice. The variety is just stunning. They'll start off with a lot of UFO calls, and the conversation quite often goes to Bigfoot. There's a high number of Bigfoot sightings. I get all kinds, you know, the mainstream Bigfoot like you would see on TV, but separate to that is a category that is invisible, that has red eyes, that has a watery look to it, and this watery figure was moving across the bush, and that's the only way you could pick it out. And then once you could pick it out, then it had red eyes, and I believe that was at Snag. And in Carcross, high Bigfoot report area there. I actually have an ornament on the counter, and it represents a report of someone seeing a group of Bigfoot as though they were having a ceremony together. The more recent and dramatic alien encounter happened here in Granger last August. A fellow taking a shortcut through the Greenbelt at night and came up, met, I call him an alien person because he was upright, but he had four legs and long toes, gray skin, 6 foot tall. So the guy was completely terrified and immediately called the UFO hotline, so away I went. My camera. Now I'm hearing about other reports in the Mount Seema area and in the Dease Lake area and the Fish Lake Road area. But I'm ever so lucky that the people involved were able to draw enough of a photograph for me to work with. And the other is my first video footage given to me. It was a copy of a flight leaving Whitehorse going to Vancouver. It was November 25th, and having a UFO stay with it for 25 minutes. And there was a passenger sitting at the wing who held his camera until his arms ached, photographing the UFO. Looking at it in an objective way, it seemed like a fairly small UFO. However, it caused a sense of fear in the passengers, and at two points in the flight, it shot off lights high and low, at which point a bubble-like turbulence was on the fuselage of the airplane. Rather than, you know, on your normal flight, people are chit-chatting. There was none of that. And when they landed in Vancouver, normally there's a chit-chat, a relief, oh, we landed. There was none of that. There was just a general feeling in the air of fear. And that was very distinctly different from any of the flights that he had been on. The more phone calls, the better, or feel free to walk up to me in my vehicle and talk to me about Bigfoot, UFOs, current, past, supernatural, spirits. I enjoy it all.